My name is Olivia Capraro. I am a multimedia journalist at WPRI 12. So in my role that I work for specifically, I work with local businesses on a project called Who to Know. This is where I interview local business owners and create a 90-second video with footage that I shoot and I edit. And then the 90-second video is used on air and online.
Awesome. Thanks. In addition to the specific position you fill there, could you give an overview of some of the other types of work that are performed at WPRI?
WPRI is one out of 171 other TV stations in the country under Nexstar Media Group. So Nexstar Media Group is one of the largest TV station operators in the country, actually. WPRI specifically is known for broadcasting 12 news and delivering quality television both on air and digitally on our website. So that's WPRI.com. Opportunities are endless, honestly, from working in the newsroom to sales to operations and digital technology. Honestly, the list of opportunities is endless. And so whether you're just looking to start your broadcasting career or maybe you're ready to take that leap into a larger market, Nexstar as an organization offers a broad range of these opportunities. And as your experience and ability, talent and ambition grow, so does your options with Nexstar Media Group.
What does WPRI look for in new employees? What education or career field skills, and also what soft skills?
As far as my position, I know that they were looking for a bachelor's degree in either journalism or communications. So as far as your education goes, those are two of the bigger degrees that they're looking for. And as far as soft skills, here's just a few. Excellent communication skills, I think, are the number one, whether it's just like having a friendly conversation with someone or having that on-air presence. So you have to be able to both communicate in person, through different through different things online. So being able to communicate properly through the newscast specifically. You also need to be reliable, you need to be flexible, you need to be able to meet deadlines, prioritize assignments, and also handle multiple tasks at once. You have to have the ability to take initiative and complete tasks, not because someone's telling you that they have to be done, but because you just know. Just take that initiative and just go for it. I think that's the number one thing that I can suggest, because that's something that they really look for. And also, I would say that having some experience in video and audio editing is definitely helpful. It may not be for your role specifically that you think you might have to use it, but now in this industry, people are known as like one-man bands where they have a hand in everything. So similar to my position, you would think that I'm just the on-air aspect, but I'm behind the scenes doing all the camera work, doing all the editing. So to have those skills of the camera work and the editing definitely comes in handy when applying for a job. Having that on your resume, they see that and they're excited.
As far as you know, what is the job outlook for entry-level employees over about the next year?
So as far as getting into the position goes, or any position at the station, I think that something that has to be made clear is that you may have to do your due diligence before getting into that position that you really want. So maybe your ultimate goal is to be a newscaster, and that's great, but they do look for that experience, whether you're working in a TV station or whatever it might be. So I would suggest getting into a entry-level position, such as maybe running the teleprompter or being the cameraman, or maybe being the overnight producer or the overnight director, things like that, where it might not sound so appealing, but they see that you're putting in the work, they see that you're doing your due diligence. That'll just open up more opportunities for you in the future as well. I can definitely say that there's a lot of training, both in person and online as well. So whether you're working directly with these people in the station. So for instance, I was, when I first got into the station, I had an internship with the road show. So not only was I working with all the hosts and the producers and the directors and the cameramans, but I also had a lot of online training as well. So the training that they put you through is definitely extensive, but also very knowledgeable. And as you go, you can just feel the experience, feel even more experience as you go.
So Olivia, do you have any advice for current CCRI students looking to join your field or your company?
So the number one thing I always say to people is I just drive home the aspect of getting an internship and how important that can be for your career. So wherever you can get it, it doesn't necessarily have to be in a TV station. They look for something where you have a little bit of experience. Maybe it's working with cameras, maybe it's working with production, specifically internships with WPRI. They had things such as working in the sports department, in the newsroom, for the road show. It's not just one thing, one internship for the whole station. You get to kind of like, you get to pick where you think that you'd like to be and feel it out. Honestly, if I'm being honest, I wasn't really sure if this is the industry I really wanted to go into. You know, you're coming into your graduation, you get this internship, you're like a little nervous, you're hoping that it's gonna work out for you. You're not really sure. So you really just gotta take your time, do as many internships as possible. While you're in that internship, ask to be in different positions as well. So although I might be specifically roadshow, I'm also asking if I can be on the production side of things. I'm also asking if I can run the teleprompter or be in the producer's chair. So I would just say take advantage of that wherever you can, because the internship aspect I think is really valuable. Another thing is just to be friendly and helpful. That was my number one thing in my internship. So anybody that I spoke to, I was just as friendly as possible. I was trying to just letting them know that I am there to help and I can do whatever I can and make their experience a good one. So, and people remember that going forward. So that's where those connections come into play. That's where you're, even though you're just being friendly, you're almost networking. So you don't know who you're going to run into or who's going to help you in the future. So just be friendly, just be helpful, and hopefully they'll use you as a reference going forward.